Hello, my dear students. How are you? Hope you are all locked down due to this pandemic coronavirus 2019, and you are locked up in the home and you cannot go out. Schools, college, everything is closed. Offices are closed, but there are certain things which are not closed. Your study should not be closed. Your exercise should not be closed. Your yoga and other things should not be closed. And their communication with the students and teachers is not locked out. So from that point of view, I'm making this video for all of you of become second sem students, so that I can reach you. My video will if my video helps you, please tell us, give me feedback, and I'll be making more such videos in future and in the topic relevant which you feel difficult. You just send it to me to my WhatsApp, or you can inbox me in my Facebook. And I'll definitely make these types of more videos and send to you if you like it. And today I have taken one very important paper, the topic, the management accounting. Yes, many students, when I teach in the class also, they get a lot of interest in the subject management accounting. And the most important thing is that this subject also get a lot of interest in teaching management accounting. And there are a lot of things, and let's start from the beginning. When you say management accounting, there are two words in this subject. One is management, another is accounting. See, for centuries together, for 3000 years back also, you may find that in the history there was accounting. Accounting evolved thousands of years back, and also management, some sort of management was there in this world. This form or that form management was there. But this management and this accounting, these are two different subjects, and they were different only after 1950. Why I'm mentioning about 1950? What happened in 1950? First time in America, there was a conference. In America, there was a conference, and organized by Anglo-American Productivity Council. And in this seminar, you know, like this conference, lots of accountants and teachers and authors and many people of the commerce background and industry, they came there, and the seminar was organized in USA, and it was organized by Anglo-American Council on Productivity. Please remember, Anglo-American Council on Productivity. So what was there exactly in this conference? In this conference, discussion was held on accounting and also management, and it was felt that management without accounting is actually blind, and accounting without management is just useless. This fact was felt at that time, that management and accounting should be combined and a new subject should be developed. And from that time, from that conference in 1950 in USA, organized by Anglo-American Council on Productivity, the management accounting, this new subject came up. And from then onwards, we are now learning management accounting, teaching management accounting. Now, let's see exactly, I have told you how the subject evolved, how the subject was formulated, or the subject was born in 1950 in the conference in America. The conference was organized by Anglo-American Council on Productivity. And let's now see exactly what is management accounting. Lots of definitions are given by different authors and different organizations. Let's first take the definition given by the same organization, that is Anglo-American Council on Productivity. They said that the presentation of accounting information in such a way as to assist the management in the creation of policy and the day-to-day operation of an undertaking. So see how Anglo-American Council of Productivity is defining management accounting. They say that the presentation of accounting information in such a way as to assist the management in the creation of policy and the day-to-day operations of an undertaking. What does it mean? So they're starting with the word presentation. The most important thing here is the word presentation. They're starting with the word presentation. They're saying presentation of accounting information. What does it mean? That accounting information is always there, already there. Financial accounting and say cost accounting is already there. This information have to be presented in a different way, presented in a special way, presented in an understandable way, presented in a clear way. For whom? For the management. Why? Because management takes decision. So if management takes decision on the basis of accounting, accounting should be presented in a systematic manner, in a special manner, so that management gets it easy to understand and take the decision accordingly. Now here we find that the presentation of accounting information, if we say, it means that management accounting is not a different type of accounting as such. Like in financial accounting, we do journal, ledger, balance sheet, etc. etc. to make. And there is no such different type of making accounts here. But the same journal, ledger, balance sheet, tables, what we have made in financial accounting, that accounting is actually used, I mean, presented in a different way so that management can take decision. So management accounting, you can say, everybody is given the definition with the same way. You'll find the language may be different, but the sense is same. So what they say, management accounting is actually presentation of the accounting information in such a way that management can take decision. Let's see one more account definition given by American Accounting Association. It's popularly known as AAA, American Accounting Association. They are saying the methods and concepts necessary for effective planning, for choosing among the alternative business actions, and for control through the evaluation and interpretation of performances. So what AAA is saying, they're saying the methods and concept necessary for effective planning, for choosing among alternatives. So you see, when you do a business, you have to take decision. And when you go for taking decision, lots of options will come to you. Different types of decisions will come to you. So you are confused which decision is best, which decision you should take, because a lot of options are there. Which option is the best one? These things are there. And it is management accounting which will show you that this decision is best, this decision should be taken, that decision should not be taken. So this way, management accounting helps in choosing the best option out of the different options given. But here also, actually, the same thing is there, the presentation of financial accounting and other accounting, whatever accounting you've already done, that accounting has been presented in such a way so that you can understand that which decision should be taken so that you can take the day-to-day decisions about management. So we have found here that management accounting is nothing but the same accounting which you have done in financial accounting, cost accounting, but the presentation is different. So it all matters on presentation of accounting. Now, here one thing I must tell you, that management accounting, actually, it is the best way. In your life also, you'll find that whatever you take, whatever you have already in past, you cannot change it. But whatever you are having in future, you can do something for that. In business also, whatever has happened in past, you cannot do anything with that. But whatever is there in future, you can dream for the future, you can plan for the future, you can say mold the future to your favor. So this way in business, this way in life, personal life, everywhere, future matters most. Past is there. You have to take experience from past. You have to take the data from the past. But ultimately, what you are doing, you have to do for future, because you cannot change your past. It is already done. But experience is already there. You cannot worry about past. In personal life, it may be there. In management accounting, in business, the same thing is there. So the experience of past can be used for future, because you never take a decision for the past. You always take decision for the future. And management accounting helps you to take decision for the future. In business, in personal life, in everywhere, you have to take decision for the future. So here we end up, again, just repeating one thing. Management accounting is not a different type of accounting. It is same accounting which you have found in financial accounting or cost accounting, but it is presented in a different way, presented in a special way, so that the management can take decision properly for the day-to-day activities of the business. So thank you very much. Hope this video is going to help you. And next, I'll be coming with more new videos, better videos. I mean, other topics. And if you find any topic which you want to know from me, please WhatsApp me or inbox me. Thank you very much. All the best.